Good afternoon, guys. So, have you guys ever sat in class at one point in your college career or in high school and wondered yourself, wow, what am I really learning? Well, I have. I sat there and said, wow, I better listen. I better listen because I want to make an A in that class, right? Well, here at Aero Consulting, we inspire students not to attain knowledge for its power, for its highest purpose, development and care. We're here today to propose to you a few recommendations, but before then, I'm going to pass it on to Amber, and she's going to introduce you to the Aero team.
Okay, like he said, my name's Amber, but his name is Amira. He's the director of communications. He's been with us for 8 years. He has a master's degree in marketing and mass communication. Next is me. My name is Amber Starks. I'm director of marketing. I have 10 years with the firm. I have a PhD in mass communication and psychology. Next is Lysandra. Associate Director of Marketing. She's been with us for 5 years. She has a master's in mass communications and marketing. Next is Malik. Malik is an external communications coordinator for our firm. He's been with us for only about 2 years, and he has a master's degree in marketing. Darian Coleman. Darian is our marketing coordinator. She's been with us for about 9 years. She has a master's degree in marketing and advertising. Brooke is our director of HR. She's been with us for 6 years and has a master's in mass communications and business. So, about Aero, getting to know us. We built our firm a little bit after No Child Left Behind Act. No Kid Child Left Behind Act was established in 2001. We believe that you gotta shoot beyond the stars to achieve your goals. You just can't make it to the sky and then what you're gonna do is stop doing all your work? No, we believe that you gotta continue to push and work hard for your goals because you never wanna maintain. We established in Atlanta, Georgia, and that's where our main firm is. And we launched in creating this consulting organization to assist students across the nation. So we try to work with our mission is to strive to inspire students to attain knowledge not for its power, but for higher purpose, the development of character. The sky is not the limit. Our goal is to help all students from primary institutions to higher level institutions and aiding them all in becoming their best ability. Okay, some of the clients we work with is Syracuse, University of Georgia, Auburn University, and Georgia State. And we also work with Sylvan Learning Center. I don't know if you guys know about Sylvan Learning Center. But a little bit after 2001, when they opened up, they were really helpful to primary kids, students in primary schools, and middle schools. So I'm going to pass it down to Darian.
Hi. Hi, everyone. My name is Darian, and I'm here with the Statement of Needs for the Academic Center for Success. After conducting student surveys, we found that 49% of the students have never heard of the Center for Academic Success. Well, they never used it. 25% of those students have never heard of it. So, the Center for Academic Success needs more awareness in order to increase student interaction. The following areas need more improvement. Communication. We have helped many organizations over the course of 5 to 10 years facilitate and encourage communication between employers. By developing a working communication strategy. An effective communication strategy is needed for vital daily operations of the organization. I'm trying to remember. The next one is marketing. Our professionals are ready to help the center get exposure and needs by creating a marketing strategy based on your needs. Without marketing, the potential clients will never know what you have to offer. There are many companies relying on our consulting business to draft business plans, strategize marketing companies, and revamp their overall reach. And I'm going to pass it over to Malik with the Chandra.
Okay, hi everybody. So the intercommunication and the academic center for success, you know, they communicate a lot through electronically, orally, and written. Through the emails, they find it more easier to communicate through emails because, you know, a lot of the employees are students, and, you know, it's not time-consuming just to log on to an email. But then the con of that is that, you know, they might use that as an excuse, well, I didn't get the email, and I ain't able to the jump mail. You know how y'all do. So with the email, then they also send employee surveys. They send employee surveys. The employees would take the survey to say what they need improvement on, what we're doing well, and how can we make certain things better. They also send reminders about upcoming events, upcoming workshops, and reminders. A lot of reminders about all type of events and meetings and important things. The oral communication is demonstrated through the face-to-face communication, telephone, speaking over the phone, you know, calling your cell phones, calling the work phone. They also text each other, you know, with the people that have each other's numbers. And I also compared it to the Division of Academic Enhancement at the University of Georgia. And they pretty much do the same thing. But one thing I think that we can learn from them is that they do video chats. They do a lot of handouts. They do group things like over a break, over Christmas break, over Thanksgiving break. They do a lot of workshops over videos. And they also have GroupMe. And they communicate a lot over social media platforms like Facebook and Twitter. Pass it over to you.
The problem with external communication is that it doesn't reach, students don't get the message. Email is the largest, has the owner's drive. It's the largest way that the SI instructors communicate with students. But we get emails all the time, and it's not like we check it. So we tend to miss these emails. It's good that it reaches a lot of people, but it's not efficient because people don't open it. And we have student instructors who sit in the class with, that they tutor, so they know what the kids are learning and what they need to know to pass the test. And there's also a mobile and social media account. Who knows about the social media account that the Center of Academic has? No one. That's a problem. Kids now are on their phones, everything's mobile, everything's social media now. So we need to expand that, market that, get more followers. Now you can't really see it here. This is the Twitter page. There's only 100, they're only following 122 people, 76 followers. Now we know social media world, that's a terrible ratio, especially if you want to reach a large amount of people. There's thousands of students at West Georgia, and only 76 people follow this. We want to gain these followers so they know when tutoring's available, how they can reach tutoring, and how they can improve their grades. And for the SI instructors, they're just like normal students. They're busy. We want to have more SI leaders, and we want them to be more open to help. I've talked to certain people, and they've had pretty bad experiences with their SI instructors. They don't respond, always busy, never there. So we want to train these SI instructors to help make it more comfortable for you to come and get help. I want to pass it off to Brooke.
So I'm Brooke, and I'm going to be going over some of the recommendations that we made for the Center for Academic Success. The first one I want to touch on is department image. One thing that we suggest is to retrain and hire knowledgeable employees. Employees, and especially the SI leaders, should be knowledgeable in what they are teaching, the material of the courses, and it's not good when a student or the leader is just as confused as the student is. It's not an effective tutoring session. And in addition to that, we also want to boost employee morale. The tutor should be passionate about what they're doing and excited about what they're doing. If they have an attitude or if they just really act like they don't want to be there, it's going to reflect on the student's attitude and also reflect poorly on the department. So what we suggest for that is to have employee workshops to refresh on the material and make sure everyone's on the same page, and also have employee activities to kind of bond everyone together and kind of make it more of a fun job for the employees. We also want to improve the marketing techniques. The Center for Academic Success, you do have a Instagram and a Twitter that are active, however, you are lacking a student following. And one way you can improve that is by following students on their social medias and also connecting with them, having like engaging things, having them respond. You respond to them. If they have questions, they can ask it through that. So that's a good way to connect and boost the image and show that you're reliable. Next, for student involvement. One way that we can get more students involved is to focus on the underclassmen. I know, and all of you can probably relate, the first year of college is a huge transition academically. And we can all probably relate to that girl up there from our freshman year. I know that's how I was. And my freshman year, I had heard of the Center for Academic Success, but I didn't really know what it was. I didn't know where it was. I heard about it a few times, but if we can reach out to those freshmen going to UWG 101 classes, residence halls, orientations, we can help them get off to a good start sooner than later. And another way to increase student involvement is to make it known that tutoring is for all students. I know a lot of students are often like embarrassed about going to tutoring and have a bad connotation with it. But one way we can do that is providing student testimonies. You can post those on the social media pages, or even when they come in to speak to, you know, residence halls or orientations, have a student speak to them. It's more effective if a peer, someone they can relate to, is telling them about their personal experience rather than an adult who may not know firsthand the benefits. And then for external communication, we suggest that the department should host more fun events and exciting events for students to attend. And you can figure that out by having student surveys, figuring out what they most likely want to get out of an event. And also incentives are a good way to get students to come to your department and be more aware. One way that we come up with is a raffle basket each time a student comes to the department and either goes to a tutoring session or goes to a study workshop. They can put their name on a ticket in a raffle basket, and as students attend sessions and put in tickets, they'll also be able to see a positive correlation with their grades and hopefully continue to use the department. And then also extra credit. The department could also work with professors to figure out if there would be any extra credit or any like class rewards for going. It would obviously be up to the teacher's discretion, but it's a suggestion that the department could make. And I'm going to pass to Alex Bird.
So in conclusion, you've heard our proposal and our recommendations. We believe students have two options, either succeed or fail. At Arrow, we don't believe in failure. We believe we want to make one path, and that one path to be succeeding through the Center of Academic Success. As we leave you, we're going to hand you out our business cards and give you some Jolly Ranchers, so this way you have good taste in your mouth when we leave.
All right.
Okay, thank you, Team 5. Let's see what kind of questions from the audience.
What risks are involved if we use your recommendation?
I don't believe that there are any risks with using our recommendations. If you choose Arab Assault, the only way to go is up.
Why should we trust your recommendation to improve our department or organization in the future?
You guys should trust our recommendations because there is no reason not to trust them. Why would you want your students to fail? So I believe that if you target the student, the center of academic success, you're targeting everyone. It'll decrease the transfer rate, it'll decrease the dropout rate, and it'll just help students succeed. So like she said, it's a little bit up.
Okay. How much time and effort will we need to put the recommendations in place?
I say about 6 months. 6 months being because we have to, like she said, we want to target the underclassmen. So every time a new semester starts, we want to target the freshmen. We want to make sure that we're also targeting people that take online classes. So we have to be able to reach those people. And the first couple months, we want to start off by just handing out flyers and talking to students and getting other students who've actually been to the Academic Center of Success to talk to kids that haven't been or are scared to go or even want to apply for jobs. Because I feel like once you have a friend that works there, it's like it's easy. And then that friend can refer you to someone else. So we want to make sure that we target everybody. So we say about a semester long.
Okay.
It will be a smart choice because it won't help just the students, it will help the whole entire university. We're here to make, to pass and get degrees, and we need good grades to do that. So our help with the tutoring center will get students help and we'll make it easier for them to pass tests, pass classes, and to get that degree.
Tell me again how your recommendations will improve our department's image.
Our recommendations will improve our department's image because it will really get the department out there more, and especially with the like going in and improving the employees and working with them, working internally will benefit us.
Why do you believe your recommendation of focusing on underclassmen will increase student involvement?
Well, like Brooke said, you know, her question on the problem. She was basically saying, like, it's gonna help because if we focus on the people that's coming in, that's what we primarily need to focus on. The students that are coming in, they new, they need more focus. Like,
Wait, if we focus on students that are coming in, then it creates a trend for those students that continue to come through. So this way we spread the word to the students coming in as well. So if a senior starts using Center of Academic Success as a freshman, someone he's a senior, one day he'll be telling freshmen, juniors, etc. The Center of Academic Success actually helps. I just saw on the Twitter page, we only got 76 followers. So let's approximately say there's 13,600 students at the University of West Georgia. 100 of them are using it. So if we can create that trend will lead to possibly potential growth within the Center of Academic Success.
All right, any other questions? Okay, thank you very much.